So where does the Hydro Majestic fit into this? Because if you even just loosely know about the Blue Mountains, you know about this amazing hotel called the Hydro Majestic.
It's beautiful, isn't it? It's the palace in the mountains. Mm. So Mark Foy, who was a retailer that made his money out of a shop down in Sydney, he actually built it in 1904. And it opened on the 4th of July 1904, 4 days before Sydney got electricity. So it had electricity before Sydney did. It was huge.
Well done.
But it did open, though, as a hydrotherapy location. Mm. So it was all about the diet and the water treatments and things like that that you could do there. And that did well for a little while. The water had to come across from Germany. The water stunk. And so, therefore, after a while, people went, nah, I'm not going to do that. So he changed his business idea. 18 months later, he changed the profile. And what he did, what he decided to do was, let's open it up. Let's bring the champagne back. And needless to say, the parties happened. It was the Great Gatsby, if we can possibly use that context, here in the Blue Mountains. Politicians, Indian Raj, we had Arthur Conan Doyle. And of course, we know him, the fantastic author. Guess what he did when he was up there? He did a seance.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, absolutely. So these are the people that were coming here. Of course, you know, our opera star, Dame Melba, and these wonderful Sydney and international socialites in the roaring 20s would draw themselves to the property so that they could stay there at the beautiful Hydro Majestic.
So it went from health benefits to party time.
The irony is not lost on me. Absolutely. In fact, actually, as you checked out, there was actually a confession booth that you could go to and confess your sins.
No.
At the seriously, it's kind of like the old take of what goes on tour stays on tour.
Stays on tour, I know
that.
Well.
Absolutely.
I love it.